Hi, it's Mike Varty from Scriptford Jesters, Tyr, Credo, Landmark, Shadowland, and you're watching Live Prog.
How many times I've said it, but 2011 is a great year for music. There are so many fantastic releases coming out. And didn't you enjoy that piece of music you just heard? This is neo-prog at its best. I dare say that this track and this album, well, it gives back neo-prog its good name, because it apparently nowadays a lot of people think neo-prog is not such a great stream or style of music. The band we're talking about is this band. Hope you can see it. Yeah. Introitus. Now, I made one mistake to Google that name. So, well, if you're curious, do it, go ahead. But it turns out that this word, introitus, means either a certain part of a female body or something part of a religious mass. So I'd like to skip that and move on to the fact that introitus is to me one of the musical surprises in 2011. Their second album is called Elements, and well, you heard a little bit of how they sound. And well, I gotta tell you, this is from the first track of the album, which is called The Hand That Feeds You. And this track lasts 14 minutes, I have to look because it's a little, 14 minutes and 18 seconds, and well, for me, 14 minutes and 18 seconds of pure bliss. Pure, well, ear porn, I'd almost say. This is fantastic music, and the whole album is just like that. Now, what makes music special? What makes music interesting to listen to? It's, of course, the feeling you get, and it's often the chemistry between the musicians. And I can say that Introitus has a secret ingredient. I mean, they have the beautiful, the really, really stunning synthesizer and keyboard parts of Mats Bender, the founder of the band. But they have a secret ingredient. Check him out. Interesting that Introitus is a bit of a family affair. Well, I'd probably say cliche, and it's been said a lot of times before, but I think they're a bit of the Kelly family of Prague. Because from the seven members of Introitus, four are related. We have Mats Bender, the father. He's playing all the keyboards and, well, wrote most of the songs. We have Anna Jobsbender, the mother. She does the vocals and, well, stunning singer. I was surprised by how good the vocals are. And then we have Johanna Bender, the daughter, who plays some percussion, some keyboards, and also does vocals. And we have the son, Matthias Bender, on additional drums and also on vocals. Now, the secret ingredient you just heard, his name is Par Helje, and he does lead guitars, and throughout the album he lays down some amazing guitar riffs, beautiful solos, and I think this is a guitar player to keep an eye on, because he's really good. Well, Let's finish the lineup then. We have Hendrik Björlind, who also does guitars, who also does flutes and some vocals. And last but not least, Dennis Lindqvist, who does bass. So it's a 7-person band. A lot of musicians, but well, given the result, they do a great job. Now, as I said, this is an album that gives Neo-Prague its good name back, because it is absolutely Neo-Prague. But the first track you heard, later on in the album, they kind of change it. So it's not just one style throughout. They add folky elements, they add all kinds of different moods and atmospheres to the album. Listen for yourself to Like Always.
Don't wanna change a thing, just to stay here, my love. We can love and live like always.
The album contains 9 tracks, and it can be divided into 2 parts. You have the actual songs, like The Hand That Feeds You, like Always, Restless, Dreamscape, Soulprint. Those are the longer songs. As I said, the first song sounds almost 15 minutes, the last song almost 17 minutes, and then a couple that are a little shorter but still quite long. And then you have the other part, which are songs that are between 1 and 2 minutes long. And these 4 songs are Earth, Wind, Fire, and Water. And there we have the title of the album, Elements. Now, these 4 songs, how do I say it? They're nice, but they are more filler tracks, you know? They set the mood for the next track to come. They're mainly instrumental, and they're mainly more like soundscapes. So basically, I'd say these 5 songs are what this album is all about. Those are the songs that I absolutely love. And I gotta say, Introit, this was a real surprise to me. When I got the album, I was very curious, and well, maybe you get the same feeling when you heard the first track at the beginning of this review, but that track got me excited. And this album is very varied. It's not just the same sound throughout the album, no. They have a lot to offer, and I can only say, well, this is a really fantastic album. I can highly recommend it. I really hope that they will come to Holland one day to play live, because, well, I think it would be a treat to see these people live on stage bringing this fantastic music. So, well, I'm going to leave you with the last part of Soulprint, the last track. I hope you enjoyed Introitus. Check them out on introitus.se, they're a Swedish band. So, have fun listening to Introitus, and see you on the next review at liveprog.com.